Okay, this is the final part of the course on longitudinal model of networks, and we will talk about actor-oriented models. So this is more refined model, more precise models, where the effects are no more isolated, like the independent arcs and reciprocity model was isolated because every dyad or links were seen as independent. But here the effect depend on a wider range of action. It takes into account neighbors and patterns. The idea is to modeling the macro structure, so the network, by choosing some micro process. This process occurs at the nodal level. So by making the node change their ties, we are trying to find the way they do that, so the network will be as it is. So basically, the idea is to see each node as an actor who has the control on its outgoing links. So every node can choose to create a link with one of its neighbor, or to destroy an existing link with one of its neighbor. There is some principles to this kind of models. So we assume that the network changes one link at a time. It's called a mini step of change, and this mini step occurs at a given time for a link. So the question is, when does it occur? And this mini steps occurs for a specific link between two specific nodes I and J. So the question is, where does it occur? And these two questions, so the answer to these two questions, where and when, may depend on the network structure and additional variables that are called covariates or covariables. So the components of this model, there are two main components. The first one is the rate function. The rate function is like the intensity matrix in the Markov chain of the previous models. It defines the moment when a link is likely to change. So it is determined stochastically by a rate function. And this rate function should be constant for every node, or may depend on some nodal characteristics. If you want to give some nodes the opportunity to change more than links than the other, it's still possible. The second component of actor-oriented models is the objective function, and this objective function is a guide that is used for a node to choose the link to be removed or added with another node G. This objective function is assumed identical for every node, but we can use covariates to make the objective function different from one node to another. But the form, the mathematical form of the function is the same for every node. And you can see that as a myopic stochastic optimization. Myopic because the nodes that choose to create or to destroy a link only anticipate the state of the network at one step in time. And this is stochastic because you can add a noise is added to the objective function to make the process of link creation or destruction not deterministic. So this is the two components that define an actor-oriented model. And we will see example of specification of the objective function to model the preference of nodes in link creation or destruction. These objective function have been at the origin developed for social networks analysis, where nodes were people. But for geographical networks, nodes are space units or firms. And if you take, for example, a network of cities, you cannot say that a city have some preferences to create some link with another city. But for the same reason as for crab correlation, since the people inside the firms make some choice of creating some links with some other people in other firms, and that these firms are in cities, the construction of a network of cities can be used for with actor-oriented models. So when you consider networks of cities, you cannot consider that network of cities that cities can decide which city to create a link, but since the actors inside the city decide to create some links, it still holds. So, specification for objective function. You can consider a density effect, an out degree effect for a link for a node I. So this first effect, Si1, is the sum for every neighbor j of I of the links ij. Reciprocity is a product between xij and xji, so this is positive only when there is reciprocal ties. If it misses a link, the value is zero. Transitivity is pretty much the same thing with three nodes, so ijk, and this is positive when there is a transitive link, so I is connected to J and J is connected to K. You can include, for example, the effect of the geodesic distance. So this effect could be the number of nodes that are situated at the geodesic distance 2 from the node I. And you can use some covariable effect. For example, dyadic covariate effect. So for every dyad between I and its neighbor j, you can take into account the effect of a variable of the link, a link variable, that has been here centered. We have removed the mean value of the variable. And finally, when you have node variables, covariates, you can add some effect, for example, let's say dissimilarity, to represent the fact that there is more chance of a link between two node ij if their variable v is very different. So this is modeled by this kind of effect. So for every link between I and j, this quantity will be high if there is a big difference between the variable of the node I and the variable of the node j. There is a lot of other effects to be included in actor-oriented models, but this is some simple example to understand. So, you choose the effect you want to test. You make some hypothesis about the effect, the local process effects that make the networks you have like it is, and you postulate that this process, this effect, will orient the choice of the nodes into the creation or the destruction of the links of your networks. You obtain the objective function by making the weighted sum of every chosen effect, Sik. It's in fact very similar to a regression, but instead of log linear or linear regression, you make a regression between the network structure configuration and some microprocesses undertaken by nodes. So in fact, you say that the future configuration observed of your network will be the result of a combination of all these local process effects. Of course, complex effects involving several interdependent features of the networks make calculation impossible, so we still simulate the evolution. So it can be shown that actor-oriented models is a Markov chain, and this can be simulated like before. So you sample the weights of your objective function, you pick a node at random according to the given rate of the rate function. This node choose at random, This node I choose its neighbor j according to the result of the objective function with parameter beta. the link between I and j is changed. So if it was 0, it becomes 1. And if it was 1, it becomes 0. You do that for every node and every link. So a sufficient number of times for the networks to be sufficiently changed according to the objective function. You repeat these three steps. And if the simulated network, so if the modification of your current network by the process of the nodes make your modified network closer to the next observation of your data, it means that you have some parameter beta that are quite good. So you keep them and you iterate until you have sufficiently iterated to have the best beta parameter, so the best objective function that describes the process that make your network from one observation to the other. Okay, this is the end of this course. This was a really complex tools to develop. So there is a lot of literature on Markov chains, Markov processes, estimation via simulation. So you just type into Google Markov chains to have a lot of references. Here we have explained the Markov chain for network evolution models. So the main contributor to this field is Tom Snyder, the creator of the Siena software and package for R. You can find a lot of documentation on the webpage of the project. What we have seen here is not so different than exponential random graph models, which is the next course topic, and which has many common elements with what we have seen here. And you can check this reference. So the article are a little bit tough to read, but Snyder's make a lot of effort to properly explain that. And he also has written the chapter 11 of this book in a clear way. And I use this chapter a lot to survive into making this course. So I thank you for your attention.